My dear students, I welcome you in the lecture series of Basics of Mechanical Engineering. Today, we are going to talk about the fourth chapter in our syllabus, that is nothing but the refrigeration and air conditioning. We have already covered three chapters titled as Introduction to the Mechanical Engineering, Steam and Steam Generator, and Introduction to the IC Engine. So, in this particular chapter, let's talk about the motivation. So at the end of this particular chapter, you will know more about the refrigeration. You have already heard about the ton of refrigerator, or we can say that when you go to a like a shop to purchase any like air conditioning, you think about the capacity of refrigerator air conditioner in terms of the ton. So we will discuss about the what do you mean by ton of refrigeration. Then you will definitely know the difference between refrigerator and air conditioning, and in the later part you will definitely know the difference between window AC and split AC, because initially window AC was booming, but nowadays window ACs are completely replaced by the split air conditioning unit. So at the end of this particular chapter, you will know these four terms, and that's only you are interested to know more about this particular chapter. So before we start our discussion, let's talk about the refrigerator. So we know that a heat engine takes heat from a hot body at a higher temperature and it rejects the energy to the cold body at a lower temperature, and that is nothing but our heat engine, and heat engine is nothing but our IC engine. So whatever we have discussed in the previous chapter, that is nothing but the heat engine, which takes the heat from the hot body and rejects it the cold body. If we operate it in a reverse direction, it means the heat takes from the cold body and reject it to the hot body with the help of the external mechanical work. That is known as a reversed heat engine, and this principle is used in two devices. The first is refrigerator and second is heat pump. So here we can say that heat engine and refrigerator both are working on the opposite principle. In the heat engine, heat takes from the hot body and delivers to the cold body, where the useful work then can be obtained. Whereas in the refrigerator, the heat takes from the cold body and removes, or you can say that rejects to the hot body. But for that reason, we need to provide some external mechanical work. So in this particular discussion, we will discuss about the working of the heat pump and the refrigerator. So the first of all, for your kind information, let's talk about the heat pump. So it is a device which absorbs heat from the cold body and delivers to the hot body, as shown in this particular figure. In this device, the external work required to convey the heat from the cold body to the hot body. So here we provide some pump work. So pump work is provided externally, and which is responsible to take the heat from the cold body and delivered to the hot body. So this is nothing but the heat pump, and this is only for your kind information. Now on the same principle, another device is working, and that is nothing but the refrigerator. So which removes the heat from the cold body and reject to the hot body to maintain the low temperature for the useful purposes. In this device, external work is required to convey the heat from cold body to the hot body, and here the refrigerant plays a very important role to do such kind of work. In general word, refrigerator can be defined as it is a device or a system used to maintain the low temperature below the atmospheric temperature within the required space. Or in simple word, a refrigerator is a machine which is produced cold in a required space. Now let's talk about some application of this refrigerator. So storage and transportation of the food for the dairy products like fruits, vegetables, meat and fish. Preservation of medical, you can say that the doses like medicine and the syrup. Manufacturing of ice, processing of petroleum and other chemical products. Liquidification of gases like nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen. And comfort of air conditioning of auditoriums, hospitals, resident offices, factories, hostels, etc. So these all are the very basic application of the refrigerator. Before we talk in detail, let's talk about the ideal refrigerant. Means if we want to design one refrigerating system, so which kind of like properties we should have in that particular refrigerant. So it should have high latent heat of evaporization and low specific volume. It should have a good thermal conductivity for rapid heat transfer. It should have low specific heat in a liquid state where high specific heat in a vapor state. It should have a low saturation pressure. It should have a high coefficient of performance and it should be economical in cost. So these like characteristics or properties of an ideal refrigerant I have just shared with you for your kind information. Generally, the refrigerants which are commonly used, these are, the first is ammonia, carbon dioxide, air can be a good refrigerant, then R11, that is a trichloromonofluoromethane, then R12, that is dichlorodifluoromethane. R22, it's a monochlorodifluoromethane, or it is generally known as the Freon 22. And nowadays, in our air conditioning unit, we are using R22. Again, the technical name or a scientific name of R22 is monochlorodifluoromethane. And you may search more about on this particular discussion on the Google. The very important part, 1 ton of refrigeration. So the capacity of refrigeration system is generally exposed or expressed in terms of the tons of refrigeration. So now a ton of refrigeration is defined as the refrigerating effect produced by melting of 1 ton of ice from and at 0 degree centigrade in 24 hours. So you just imagine you have a one ton of ice. So right now that 1 ton of ice, that is at 0 degree centigrade, so the refrigerating effect is produced by melting of this 1 ton of ice at 0 degree centigrade in 24 hours. And that is equivalent to the 1 ton of refrigerator. In simple word, the 1 ton of refrigerator, that is equal to 210 kilojoule per minute. So you must remember this relationship. That is 210 kilojoule per minute. And that is equivalent to the 3.5 kilowatt. Okay, so this is only for your kind information, but you must remember the definition of the 1 ton of refrigerator. Again, in simple word, if I would like to share the definition, amount of heat required to remove in order to from 1 ton of ice at 0 degree centigrade in 24 hours from water at 0 degree centigrade. So this is another way to define the 1 ton of refrigerator. Both definitions are right. Okay, it is up to you which you would like to remember. In simple word, you just remember you have a 1 ton of ice at 0 degree centigrade. If it start melting, so the amount of energy or amount of refrigerating effect produced by melting it in 24 hours. The most important part, the coefficient of performance. When we talked about the IC engine, we talked about the efficiency. So here the coefficient of performance, that is an index, to define the like effectiveness of the refrigerator or a refrigerating effect. So the performance of the refrigerator system is expressed by the coefficient of performance, that is known as a COP. The COP of a refrigeration system is defined as the ratio of the refrigerating effect divided by the work required to compress the refrigerant in the compressor. So here we can say that COP, that is equal to refrigerating effect divided by compressor work. So in simple word, you may remember in this way. So the COP is the ratio of refrigerating effect divided by work of compressor or a compressor work. In simple word, the COP is the reciprocal of the efficiency of the heat engine. So thus, the value of COP is always greater than unity, and this is very important. When we talked about the efficiency, we discussed that efficiency value cannot be greater than 1 or 100%. The similar way, the coefficient of performance is the reciprocal of the efficiency. So the value of the COP is always greater than unity. So this is all about the a basic discussion related to the refrigerator. Now we are going to talk about the vapor compression refrigeration system. So here, this particular figure that is associated to the vapor compression refrigeration system. So the vapor compression refrigeration system is most popular and widely used in refrigeration and air conditioning for both domestic as well as industrial purposes. In the vapor compression refrigerator, vapor is used as a refrigerator. So here the vapor is used as a refrigerator. Vapor is used as a refrigerant, not a refrigerator. Vapor is used as a refrigerant. It is circulated in the system in which it alternately evaporates and condenses. Evaporates, it means convert liquid into the vapor, or condense, it means vapor to the liquid. Thus, it undergoes a change of phases. In the evaporation, it absorbs the latent heat from the space to be cooled, and in condensation or cooling, it rejects heat to the atmosphere. So we will discuss that VCR in detail. This particular flow diagram of the vapor compression refrigeration system consists four components. So the first is compressor, then condenser, then expansion, and then evaporator. And we will detail the working of each component in detail. So let's talk about the compressor. So here you just closely observe. The color I have used to write that particular component, the same color I have used to mark the arrow. So this is the in of the compressor and this is the exit of the compressor. So the inlet of the compressor. So here we have a low pressure and low temperature vapor. So here we have a low temperature, low pressure vapor enters the compressor. So compressor compresses the vapor at a high temperature and the pressure. So the condition of the refrigerant at the exit. So here we have a high temperature, high pressure vapor. Now this high temperature, high pressure vapor enters into the second component, that is the condenser. So it condensing the vapor and it will convert into the low temperature saturated liquid. So here at the exit we have a low temperature saturated liquid. Now this saturated liquid which comes out from the condenser is then entered into the expansion devices. So this is known as an expansion. So the pressure of the saturated liquid, so the pressure of the saturated liquid is what we can say, that decrease from the condenser pressure to the evaporator pressure. So here we have a low pressure saturated liquid. Now the fourth one, that is the evaporator. So this is what we have, a evaporating system. So the liquid refrigerant, so the liquid refrigerant coming from the expansion devices enter into the evaporator where the heat is absorbed. So when the heat is absorbed, So liquid will be converted into the vapor. So the latent heat of evaporation from the space to be cooled. Due to the absorption of the heat, liquid refrigerant is converted into the saturated vapor or a superheated vapor at the low pressure and low temperature. So here we have a low pressure and a low temperature vapor. Then that low temperature, low pressure vapor is supplied to the compressor. So it will be converted into the high pressure, high temperature vapor. Then vapor will be converted into the saturated liquid. Then saturated liquid will be converted into the low pressure saturated liquid. Okay, and then it will be converted into the low pressure low temperature vapor. So it is just nothing but converting the phases from liquid to the vapor and vapor to the liquid. So again, the vapor enters into the compression and the cycle is repeated. So let's talk about the function of the main parts, like what is the main function of the compressor, condenser, expansion and the evaporator. So the function of compressor is to compress the refrigerant and convert into the high pressure vapor. The same way condenser, it facilitates the heat transfer surface through the heat transfer take place from the hot refrigerant to the condensing medium. The third is expansion. So expansion is convert or vaporize. Liquid will be vaporized into the evaporator at the desired low temperature and absorb the heat from the space. And last is the evaporator. And evaporator provides a heat transfer surface through which a low temperature liquid refrigerant can absorb and convert into the vapor. So this is nothing but the working of the vapor compression refrigeration system. And I think that's all from my end as far as our today's session is concerned. We have covered the refrigerating part. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the air conditioning. So till then, you have a great time ahead. Bye.